Hey guys, Andrew here, also known as Slayer Rocker 86, and today I'm going to be showing you guys some awesome things in Minecraft 1.5. We are in the latest Minecraft snapshots, and this is the first episode of the new series where I'm going to be showing you guys some stuff that you might not have seen. These aren't just features in Minecraft 1.5, but creations made by the features, or with the features, that have been added in the latest update to Minecraft. Now, of course, if you guys want to get the latest updates in Minecraft, you guys can go to mojang.com and get the snapshots. If you don't know how to download them, you can scroll through my channel and check out the videos. And, of course, for the latest Minecraft news and coverage, you could always check it on my channel. I do them daily, or weekly at least, whenever there is news. So, behind me, I'm going to be going actually through 5 different maps. This one is Seth Blink's map. I co-hosted the boss battles for Full Screen Arcade with him last Friday. You guys can check out the live stream. I uploaded it on Saturday to my channel. If you guys want to see, it was me, him, Michael, and some of the other arcade members, and it was really cool. So if you guys want to check this this Back to the Future map, you guys can go check out his channel. It is Seth Bling. It sounded a little bit weird in my mouth because I just ate some weird stuff. But yeah, so I'll go ahead and show this and a couple other awesome stuff. Which, again, these use the brand new droppers, which also, or I think they're dispensers, I don't remember. But if you put a flint and steel in them, it makes fire. So you're gonna see something real cool. But real quick, before I start this video, I am doing a giveaway in this video because of some awesome sponsors. I can now do even more giveaways for you guys. So in this video, I will be giving away a Minecraft premium account gift code to a lucky winner, and or they get to pick between that or an Xbox Minecraft Edition gift code, so they can get the Xbox Minecraft Edition or anything on the Minecraft junk store, either being a shirt, a hoodie, a creeper plushie, or something of that sort. So if you guys want to participate, just leave a comment below with your thoughts on what you guys love about, tell me anything. What do you guys love about Minecraft 1.5? What do you want to see in the future update? Anything really, I look forward to your comments. And if this video gets 150 likes, I will pick one lucky winner. And if this video gets, I'm going to go with a high number, 400 likes. I will do 3 giveaways in this video. So that increases your chances by 3. You don't have to give a video like, but if you want to, feel free to. Let's get on with the video. So, let's show this bad boy off. Now, Seth Bling did a good job, so I'm not going to go too far into it. I just want to show off what it uses that is in 1.5, because, you know, this is a series that is highlighting what is in 1.5. And it uses a glitch that's still in the game, which is about half slabs, which are extremely glitchy. And it uses, basically, like I just said, the fact that when you go over the new, I think these are droppers or dispensers. Dispensers, yeah. If you go over a dispenser and it's aimed at something, it will burn that, and if it's looking upwards, it'll light that on fire. So, let's set this bad boy off. It's gonna go down, burning, 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 and it disappears. And that is just awesome. I definitely want to use this for some type of video series. And then it goes down here, and it would basically go around right over there. And then for it to go back up, it is actually quite simple. Let's put this one over here. Give it a little bit of a push. You guys will see it goes up there, through the little half slab, and back up over here. So, I just thought that was really cool. I'll go ahead and let me complete that little track over there so we could see it in its full little cycle. But I just thought that was really awesome. You could do a lot of stuff with these type of things. So again, that's why I highlighted this. I just thought it was really cool. Tell me guys, what do you think about it? And of course, if you guys want to go watch Seth Bling's video about it, go ahead. Almost broke that. Go ahead and check out his channel. It is Seth Bling. You guys can actually go to my channel and you can find it right there in the description. And pretty awesome stuff. Watch it go around, it'll come back up. There we go. That is just awesome. Pure awesomeness. That's why I love Minecraft. Just the creations you could do in the game. It's just absolutely incredible. Let me go ahead and turn the fire off for all of these. Let's go ahead and get in here one more time and let's see how it looks as the player going on it. Burning everything, you go, whoa, you go down here. You could really do a lot of stuff with this. And then up here, back over, I don't know if it works in survival as well, but that is the Back to the Future map. Awesome stuff, great job, Seth Blake, incredible guy. Let's go into the next one, which we have experiments. So going into this map, it is, this is the automated closet. I actually made a video about this. This guy made some amazing stuff, and I want to see if I could find his name. Follow up to do. Now I was trying to see if I could find his YouTube user somewhere over here, but it might be inside. Is it? Nope. Oh well, I made a video about it. You guys can check out the download link there. What this basically does is it uses both hoppers. I believe it uses a proximity detector type of system with, yep, it uses the comparator block, And it also uses a command block. And then the dropper, I think, I'm not 100% sure. I think it's a dispenser, I always get them confused, but let's go ahead and check it all out. And they just fit a bunch of stuff because I went within its range. So, let's put armor in here. Let's actually fully load up all the armor. Let's put a sword in there, and let's just leave it like that. I'm gonna go ahead and just put this in the inventory. And as you guys can see, I don't have any armor on me. Once I walk in here, the new feature makes it so that, oh, it puts armor on your character. So let me go over here. I have full armor, which that's just an amazing feature that these amazing dispensers now have. They will put armor on you, so the closet will fully arm you up as well as give you whatever you had set in the little inventory. So again, even more awesome stuff, and I just love 1.5, don't you guys? I don't know, this is just an incredible update. Going on to the next map over here, because it's called Inventions, I don't know exactly what it is. Oh yes, this is the automated chicken farm. I think Settling did show a video about this. I don't know if this is his though, but basically, very simple, how it works is it uses a couple of the new things that have been added in the update for 1.5, which is one, hoppers, and two, pressure rail, or not pressure rails, but pressure plates, I think. So, I'll go ahead and go right over here so you guys can see. Okay, made by that guy. So, 5 blocks wide, blah 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 blah. Works as a snapshot above. It automatically cooks food and has a manual button. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, blah 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 blah. Awesome stuff, you guys could all pause and read that. But yeah, basically what it does is, you know, you have all your chickens up here. I believe, you know, they lay their eggs and stuff. The eggs go through the hoppers, it shoots it back out. I don't know, it's a complicated process, but it's just awesome how it makes automatic chicken. You also get eggs and feathers from it. So, awesome stuff. I don't know, tell me what do you guys think. You think it's cool? I think it's cool. It probably like burns them too, so let's see. Manual lava. So yeah, it releases a chicken, the chicken gets burnt, and when it goes down, it goes into the hopper, and in the hopper, stuff goes in here. So I'll go ahead and actually clear everything in here, and I should have probably done that before I killed the chicken that was already in there. But got that in, let's hit the button again, let's see if it releases another chicken. I think I need more chickens in there, but yeah, it would have a chicken be released. Once the chicken is released, it would be down here, the lava would burn it, and then it would be dropped in here, all the stuff from it. So awesome creation, just even more innovation in Minecraft, which again, just incredible. I remember the days when the only thing that I ever had that was like, you know, redstone-y, piston-y was like TNT cannon. So you know, these new creations are amazing. And this over here takes advantage of the brand new daylight detector, or sensor, or whatever you guys call it. So let me make it time set 1700, which is nighttime. So when it turns nighttime, the signal turns off, which turns on these night lights. And of course, when you make it daytime, let's go ahead and make it daytime, time set 0. It'll make it daytime, the daylight turn off and stuff, make it nighttime again, and they turn on. So, awesome stuff. You could do a ton of huge things with this. We all knew about this awesome stuff that was going to come just when they said daylight detectors were going to be added. So, next off, we have these command block thingies over here, which when you hit them, they do cool stuff. I don't know what this one specifically does. I think this is a command block shop. So, I think this is a better example of it, I believe. Let me clear my inventory first. There we go. I believe this one gives you a sword when you step on the pressure plate by command block. I'm not exactly sure. But, clear the inventory. I don't know. I just thought, I think maybe it's this one. You go up here. Let me get in here. So, that is an iron sword. You walk up here, stand on the pressure plate, hit the button, and I think maybe it's supposed to give you a sword. I don't know, but I know you could have... Oh, there we get there, going down, going down. But yeah, I think you can, let me see. I have no idea. I think it works with... Oh, okay, okay. So it works with score kills. Right now, I have like 20. So I'm not exactly sure how it works, but apparently you can now trade in your score kill streaks, and you can get anything from it. So depending on your score, if you have some type of cool custom block like this or command block, you could have it configured so that it takes 10 from your kills or 10 XP or whatever that system is, and it'll give you something. Now the reason why this innovation is awesome is because if you were to make a fully automatic PvP type of map, you could have it so that players could go, for example, a TF2 map. You can make it so that they can go into the shop and then they can trade their kills for actual weapons or enchantment upgrades. So Again, incredible stuff that you could now do in Minecraft, made simple with command blocks and with score streaks, which can now be implemented and do a ton of amazing stuff. So, just wanted to show that off. I don't really know how this map's supposed to work exactly, but I'll show it off anyways. Maybe I have to be touching it. I have no idea. But still, awesome stuff, and there's even more things down there, which I'll cover in another video. But that was it for now, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me go ahead and get my signature short out and say goodbye. There we go. Got it all out. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed these inventions for Minecraft 1.5. This was episode 1. I will be doing a ton more coverage on all the snapshot progression and amazing things that are in the update. So yeah, if you guys want a chance to win one of the giveaway things, be sure to hit the annotation, or not the annotation, be sure to leave a like and leave a comment below. And check out the video I posted yesterday, the FRZ Live episode 1. I worked hard on that, and actually not really, but it's a pretty cool episode, and it's the start of a ton of awesome new things. And I'm doing several giveaways in that video, so check that out, guys. Thank you all for watching. I'm SlayerRock86, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.